Group and ungroup objects in pCon Planner. The group and ungroup functions allow you to efficiently organize objects in your plan. You can group them together to edit them collectively and ungroup them to separate objects. In the Edit tab, you'll find the two functions. When you select multiple articles, you can create a group by simply clicking on Group or using the keyboard shortcut Ctrl and G. Here you'll see that previously individual articles now have a common outline and can be selected as a whole group. If you're creating a plan and, for example, want to place multiple workstations in the room, you can group all the elements and distribute the workstation in your plan. By grouping these elements, you can move, scale or copy them as a single element instead of handling each individual object separately. If you want to select or edit individual objects within the group, you can open the group for editing with one click on the interactor or by simply double-clicking on a specific object. This allows you to move, rotate, scale or configure objects. This is useful if you want to make changes to the group without ungrouping it. You can copy objects within the group using Ctrl+C. As long as the group remains open, you can paste the copied object into the group using Ctrl and V. If it's closed, the object will be placed outside the group on the planning level. For example, if you want to scale an object group of models from the 3D warehouse to a different size, you can using the scaling tool in the Edit tab. Simply select a group and adjust the desired size. With this method, the scaling will be uniformly applied to all objects in the group. If you want to ungroup, you can do so by clicking the ungroup button or using the shortcut Ctrl and U. The previously grouped objects are now individual again in the plan and you can select and move them individually. Additionally, you can use ungrouping to break down 3D models into their individual components. Let's say you found an object in a 3D warehouse that meets your needs. However, the model contains additional elements that you don't want to include in your plan. By clicking ungroup, you can break the existing group and remove the desired object for your plan. If you accidentally ungroup too much and the objects are broken down into their smallest components, the polygons, you should undo the last step. Simply regrouping won't completely restore the previous object state. Groups can help you to structure your planning and improve your workflow. Watch this video to learn how you lock and unlock objects in plans. Thank you for your attention and see you next time.